found one.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? It is Captain Shock here. Today I'm bringing you some For Honor gameplay, and actually team deathmatch gameplay, or as they like to call it, deathmatch in For Honor. Now you're seeing straight away when the game starts, you will be faced against an opponent, a human opponent, and of course some of them will fight you head on, or some of them will run away and get the power ups and then come back and fight you, or even group up with their teammates who they're communicating with, and they will come back and fight you 2-on-1. And maybe he should have done that because he just got executed, boy. As for tips when playing team deathmatch, you want to get those power ups because it is very important. It will mean the chance of you clutching a vital round. And also, you need to forget about these 1v1 fights. A lot of the times your opponents won't 1v1 you, they will bring their friends and they will team up against you, so you do the same as well when you're faced in these situations. And we won the first round already. The next thing you want to do when playing team deathmatch in For Honor is play in a party, play with some friends and talk on the mic, communicate and use some strategy. Here I am playing with a Kenzai character, and I'm playing against a character which has speed on his side. So of course I trap him against the rock and I minimize the effects, the advantages that he has against me. He got destroyed there, you see what I mean? So you need to think about these things. You need to think about the characters you're using and the characters you're playing against. Think about their strengths and weaknesses and how to generally beat them. Now when you see those white crosses on the floor, that means your teammate has died and there's a chance that you can revive them. Now I encounter an enemy here, I face up with him, I put a few slashes in him, and let me see if he wants some more. Does he want some more? I lose some stamina here, I keep my guard stance, I'm waiting for him. Does he want piece of me? Nah, he runs away. Smart choice today, boy. So I go straight away to my teammate to revive him. The number one point is you want to have numbers against them. You want to revive your teammates. If there's a good chance that you can revive your teammate, then do revive him. It is a good strategy. And here I am going straight for the power up, and you can see how important it will be when I get these power ups. The more advantages you give yourself, the greater chance you have of winning the match. Now in terms of reviving your fallen teammates, you don't want to put yourself in a situation where you're gonna die trying to revive your teammate. You're just putting your team at a disadvantage. And here I am, I enter this fight, I take him out, I execute you, boy, get destroyed. Man, I love this game. Now I enter the fight against this Viking, I pin him straight against the rock. Bloodthirsty boy, get executed, that's how it's done. Which brings me to another important point. You want to execute your enemies, because if you don't execute them, you will give your enemies a chance to revive their fallen teammates. However, if you execute the enemy, there is no chance of revival for them. The next major tip is to use the environment to your advantage. If there is dynamic map movement such as this geisha, then use it and you will see, boom, get boiled up by a geisha, boy. Here I am taunting him, hopefully he learns from his mistakes there. So always be aware of the environment you're playing in, be situational aware, and also take note of where your teammates are on the minimap. Look at the bottom right, you can see where the enemies are, you can see where your teammates are, and it's easy to find and locate them, especially when they need help. And I just walk straight right in and execute this enemy, legendary. Which brings me to the other point, you don't want to waste time fighting an opponent 1v1 when you can easily 2v1 them and reduce the time it takes, because if you give them extra time, especially against good opponents, they will be in the background reviving their fallen teammates, and of course they will have that advantage and come back for you and ambush you. So be very careful of that, try not to waste any time. Here I see my teammate handling that enemy very efficiently, so I just look around checking for other enemies. And I'm keeping with my teammates as well. So you don't want to separate yourselves from your teammates too often, because if you do that, you will give them an advantage, especially if you have the numbers on them. They can easily take you out 1v1 if it's a very good opponent. So of course, always stick with your teammates when you outnumber them. And here I am, the final execution. Get wrecked, boy. Boom. Straight in the spine. That's what's up. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it informative. Please leave a like if you did, please share the videos if you want to see me grow, and do subscribe for more effective videos. Take care, bye.